Well, hello and welcome. My name is Alistair Stevenson and I'm on the ministry team here at All Saints. And I want to particularly welcome you if this is the first time that you are joining us for our online service, or if you haven't been to or engaged with All Saints before. Through this service, we would encourage you to join in with us for the hymns and songs that will come up on the screen. And you may even want to stand as we sing and join in with the actions for our all-age song. Please also do join in with the liturgy and particularly with the words in bold. As you may have seen, today is our Mission Sunday service, and we're particularly excited to welcome Anna Laszlo as our speaker. If you haven't watched her introduction on the website, I would encourage you to do so. Anna is the chair of the board of Tear Fund, and her background is in international development. So she brings a whole wealth of experience, as she will be helping us to explore mission and particularly our role in mission, even in times such as these. I really want to encourage you to also take the opportunity to look at the video updates given by a number of our mission partners. These are available on the service page for this Sunday on the website. If we were meeting in church, we would normally have had stalls set out across the church highlighting the work of our mission partners to help us to pray and support them. I think these videos are a really good substitute in these times when we can't gather, so I'd really encourage you to take time to check them out. And finally, I wanted to highlight that Thy Kingdom Come starts on Thursday. Thy Kingdom Come is a global prayer initiative between Ascension Day and Pentecost. And we here at All Saints are going to start Thy Kingdom Come with an Ascension Day praise and prayer service at 7 p.m. on Zoom in partnership with St. Gabriel's Church. We will be finishing just before 8 p.m. so that we can all go out onto the streets to join our prayers with the thanksgivings of our nation as we give thanks for the NHS. So if you'd like to join us on Zoom for that service, please do get in touch and we will send you the invitation. And so as we start our service this morning, let's join together with these opening acclamations. Do join with me with the words in bold. Let everything be said and done in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God through Jesus Christ. Sing psalms, hymns, and sacred songs. Let us sing to God with thankful hearts. Open our lips, Lord, and we shall praise your name. And so we're going to sing two songs together. We're going to sing All Creatures of Our God and King. And then we're going to sing and do join us with the actions for our all-age song, My Lighthouse. So let's sing together.
Of our God and King. My my troubled sea. Here we go. My lighthouse, shining in the darkness. I will follow you. Oh, my lighthouse, I will trust the promise. You will carry me safe to shore. Oh, 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 safe to shore. Oh, 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 safe to shore. Oh, 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 safe to shore. Fire before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storm. Before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storm. Say, fire before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us through the storms. Fire before us, you're the brightest. You will lead us.
So we come now to a time of confession, and let's just take just a few moments for ourselves to come before God and allow His Spirit to expose our hearts and look into those areas where we are broken and in need of His healing this morning. Let's take a few moments. So, Lord God, our Maker and our Redeemer, this is your world, and we are your people. Come among us and save us. We have willfully misused your gifts of creation. Lord, be merciful. Forgive us our sin. We have seen the ill treatment of others and have not gone to their aid. Lord, be merciful. Forgive us our sin. We have condoned evil and dishonesty and failed to strive for justice. Lord, be merciful. Forgive us our sin. We have heard the good news of Christ, but have failed to share it with others. Lord, be merciful. Forgive us our sin. We have not loved you with all our heart, nor our neighbours as ourselves. Lord, be merciful. Forgive us our sin. And together we pray. May God, who loved the world so much that he sent his Son to be our Saviour, forgive us our sins and make us holy to serve him in the world through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so we come to our collect for today. Risen Christ, by the lakeside you renewed your call to your disciples. Help your church to obey your command to draw the nations to the fire of your love, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. And so, before we come to God's word, we are going to sing again together, and we are going to be led by the All Saints Choir as we sing Beauty for Brokenness. Let's sing together. So we come now to our readings, and then Anna is going to speak to us. And we're really grateful that Richard Blyth and then Vicky Vidler are going to read for us this morning. And so before they do, let's just pray for God's words and for Anna as she speaks to us. And so God, we pray that your word would come alive to us this morning, no matter where we are. And that as we hear your word, and then as we hear Anna open up your word to us, that you would make yourself known in our lives, that we would be inspired and equipped for mission, for the building of your kingdom in our communities and beyond. We pray your word would speak to us this morning. Amen.
The reading is taken from Isaiah chapter 42, verses 1 to 7. Here is my servant, whom I uphold, my chosen, in whom my soul delights. I have put my spirit upon him. He will bring forth justice to the nations. He will not cry, or lift up his voice, or make it heard in the street. A bruised reed he will not break, and a dimly burning wick he will not quench. He will faithfully bring forth justice. He will not grow faint, or be crushed, until he has established justice on the earth. And the coastlands wait for his teaching. Thus says God, the Lord, who created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread out the earth and what comes from it, who gives breath to the people upon it and spirit to those who walk in it. I am the Lord. I have called you in righteousness. I have taken you by the hand and kept you. I have given you as a covenant to the people, a light to the nations, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out the prisoners from the dungeon, from the prison, those who sit in darkness.
The second reading is taken from St. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 5, verses 13 to 16. You are the salt of the earth, but if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
My grandfather was a real missionary, I used to say to my friends. And it is true, I came from missionary stock. I had great aunts who went to China. My grandfather went to Kenya, where my father was born. My parents went to Tanzania and Uganda. But what did I mean by a real missionary when I talked about my grandfather? I think I meant somebody who went to church every Sunday and preached there to people who hadn't heard the gospel before, and maybe also preached at regular evening services during the week until everybody had heard the gospel and everybody had turned to the Lord. But had I got that right? Or had I, at an age of still single figures, single digits, fallen into the trap that the church has fallen into for the last 2,000 years of divorcing the spiritual from the physical? Let's look at the start of Genesis. God made the world and he looked at it and it was good. And on the sixth day, he looked at it and it was very good. And that's not a sort of dispassionate, objective, standing back assessment. He looked at the world and he loved it. It was great. It was amazing. And then he made people within that to enjoy the world, to look after it, to care for it, to rule over it. To rule over it not as an autocratic dictator, but to rule over it in the way that God rules, with love, with care, with compassion. He didn't make us to be separate from the world. But I think that since then, many of us have fallen into the trap of saying that there is the material here and there's the spiritual here, and the spiritual is what is important. And that's where the church focuses. And for the real heavy lifting, we will appoint vicars and we will appoint missionaries. But I don't think that that's what God intends for the church. I don't think that that is what the mission is that God has given the church. So here we are on Mission Sunday, on your Mission Sunday. Let's have a think. What should we think of as mission? What do we think that God has given us as the church's mission? Let's look again at Genesis 1. Then God said, "Let us make mankind in our own image, in our likeness." So God created mankind in his own image. And now let's look at our reading in Isaiah 42. There's so much richness there. God talking to Israel, to his people, to the bearers of his promise to redeem the earth and to bring it back to himself. Wonderful pictures of how Israel, God's people, should live in this world, opening eyes that are blind, freeing captives from prison, releasing from the dungeon those that sit in darkness, being a light for the Gentiles, for those not yet God's people. Yes, we know that this prophecy and others like it were later picked up by Jesus and applied to himself and ultimately fulfilled in him. But we mustn't lose the fact that these were first spoken to Israel, commissioning them for their work in the world. And now let's look at our passage from Matthew 5. Really famous. You are the salt of the earth. You are the light of the world. Wait a minute. We are the salt of the earth? We are the light of the world? Surely that's Jesus. Jesus said, "I am the light." But no, look again. You are the light of the world. How can we be the light? But look at Genesis again. We were made in God's image. God should be seen in us, in how we live, in how we engage with the world, with the earth, with the people in it. God always intended this to be the case. When people first walked away from him, that image was dulled. But Jesus, in his rescue, reminded us how to be fully human. We should be the light, because God, in whose image we were made, is the light. That is the church's mission, our mission. Real missionaries are those who live as salt and light in the communities around them. Yes, speaking about God and his salvation, and also living it out. Living a light, a life so different that it shines out to those around them. Living out the deep compassion, the self-giving compassion that we see in Jesus. Encountering people where they are and meeting their needs, both physical and spiritual, however we can. In this, in being the light to the world, we are answering God's call from the very beginning. The call made first to Adam, and then to Israel, and then to Jesus himself. And now, through Jesus, the call comes to the church. Be the salt of the earth. Be the light of the world. At Tufan, we believe that we are here in large part to help the church to grasp that mission and to live it out. What does that look like for the church right now? I wonder what your life feels like. Mine seems to have turned completely upside down. Having rejected the idea of being a teacher many years ago, it turns out that I am actually a teacher. Not, perhaps, my 8 and 9-year-old would contend, a terribly good one. But that is how I spend a large part of my time nowadays. I juggle that with my work as youth and children's work team leader at church and with chairing Tear Fund and, along with my husband, just generally keeping the family and the house going. I am doing all this, as you will be living your lives, in a world that seems hugely constrained. I have no idea when we're next going to see our older children. I have no idea when I'm next going to see my mother, my sisters, my mother-in-law. And I know that most of you, all of you probably, are at least as affected, if not more, than I am. But at least I know that I still have money coming into my bank account, that if I'm made redundant, I will receive money from the state, that if I fall ill, I will be looked after. But around the world today, billions of people are having their lives turned upside down by coronavirus. And for many, the social distancing and the self-isolation imposed on them by their governments and by the local authorities where they live have much more drastic implications than they do for me. Heb Davi, Tear Fund's country director in the Democratic Republic of Congo, says people here live on less than $1 a day. They have to go out to find something to eat every day. That's how they live. We can use force to keep people in, but then people's fear is that they won't die of COVID, but they will die of hunger. At a certain level, people will get desperate. Imagine seeing your children hungry and crying. At that point, as a parent, you think you can't watch your children die. You have to go out to get food. Or I think of those millions of people in refugee camps around the world. Think, for instance, of Cox's Bazaar in Bangladesh, with more than 1 million Rohingya cramped together in squalid conditions. They're under lockdown. What does self-distancing look like there? It's impossible. And once coronavirus starts there, what then? how to prevent its spread, how to care for the sick, for the dying. Let's think about hand washing for a moment. We're all being advised to wash our hands with soap and water for 20 seconds. 785 million people don't have clean water close to home. You have to walk to get it, sometimes for hours, usually the women and the girls. You bring it back on your head or on your back. Washing your hands properly for 20 seconds under running water takes at least a litre. And then use that water to make sure everyone washes their hands frequently for 20 seconds. And soap? A family of five needs 150 grams of soap a week for each member to wash their hands 6 times daily. That costs about $1. So for those in the Democratic Republic of Congo and elsewhere who live on less than $1 a day, that's prohibitive. So what does being salt and light look like for the church at this time? What's our mission? How do we do it? Rosa Camargo de Bravo, who leads Tearfund's work in Latin America and the Caribbean, says, "The temple is closed, but the church is not." And this is where Tearfund's work with and through churches really comes into its own. We as a church are not a separate community. We are part of those we live among. We are called to be salt and light to the world in our communities. So, as the virus brings fear and darkness, we can bring hope and be light. And around the world, we are seeing churches stepping up, stepping out, sometimes from behind their walls, into the communities around them. A Tearfund staff member who's been visiting our projects in Ethiopia reports, "We are seeing that the poor and most vulnerable people have newfound hope as the church has reached out to their neighbours. The transformation that is taking place in communities because churches are being a catalyst for change astounds me." Tearfund is working as quickly as possible to assess how the coronavirus is affecting the world's most poor communities and how we can best support our partners and our churches to make a meaningful and sustained response, to be salt that stays salty, and to be light that continues to shine in the darkness. We've created resources containing life-saving health advice, including crucial hygiene practices to limit the spread of the virus. We've translated these into local languages and we're sharing them with communities around the world. We're training faith leaders to share accurate health information to those around them, countering the misinformation that so quickly spreads. We're adapting our programmes and we're finding new ways to safely support those in need, making sure that no one's left behind. In Afghanistan, for instance, one of our partners is working to provide counselling services to patients, to their families, and to staff dealing with the coronavirus. And we're also working alongside the health ministry there to distribute personal protective equipment to limit the spread of the virus and to help those on the front line to safely serve people in need. In Burundi, more than half the children suffer from malnutrition. Our feeding centre there provides life-saving support to new mothers and their babies. Determined to continue this vital service if the country goes into lockdown, our local partners have made plans to use home delivery kits. And these will make sure that vulnerable families still get the food and the help that they need to overcome malnutrition and survive. Tearfund is delivering emergency food and supplies. We're building water tanks. We're providing soap. And we're speaking out against the dangers of gender-based violence, which is so much more prevalent under lockdown, and helping survivors to be able to access support. We're distributing cash to vulnerable families, families who can't buy food or basic necessities. Now, of course, not all of this is through the local church, but wherever possible, That is how we work, enabling the local church to fulfil its mission, to be light in the world. What about us here, stuck in our houses, in our flats, in our rooms? Well, we too can reach out to those around us, in the communities in which we live, either directly, perhaps through a phone call, a card in the post, a Skype, offering to get shopping for those who can't get out or shouldn't get out. Or maybe by supporting local organisations that work in the towns in which we live. And I know that you support a number of organisations, missions, that work here in Sheffield. And we can reach out nationally and globally by supporting organisations that do so, that work around the country and around the world. You are one of Tearfund's strongest supporting churches, and I thank you for that. And I know that your support to the Diocese of Kilimanjaro is hugely valued by them. Thank you so much, and please keep on with that. Keep praying, keep supporting. Without your support, and without the support of churches and other individuals around this country, Tearfund would not be able to do the work that it does. I know that you also support other organisations that work nationally and that work globally. And that means so much. That is part of doing your mission of being light to the world. At this time, I'd encourage you as a church, as individuals within it, to think, where and how can you be a light to the world? Are there people you can call up today, tonight, tomorrow, to encourage, to sit with in this dark time, to bring some light, to be light? Is God calling you to give more money, more time? What's your part in the church's mission right now, right here? I am so grateful to have had this opportunity to have joined with you in your mission weekend. Thank you so much for inviting me. Thank you for not standing me down when it turned out we were going to have to do this virtually. I really look forward to meeting you one day in person, and I hope that won't be too long. But until then, please continue to pray for us, and we will continue to pray for you as we each play our part in responding to God's call, to God's mission for us, to be light and salt in this world.
So Kate Gerrish is now going to come and lead us in our prayers and to help us to further respond to what Anna has been speaking to us about. So let's pray together.
I'll conclude each section of the prayers by saying, God of love, please respond by saying, hear our prayer. Let us pray. Father God, we pray for your continued blessing on our church at this time. We ask that as a church family, our faith will be strengthened, even though we can't meet together in person. On this Mission Sunday, we pray that we might grow in our commitment to sharing the gospel through our own witness and by supporting mission partners through our church and individually. We thank you for providing for us so generously. Please help us to be generous in supporting mission through prayer, encouragement, practical involvement, and financial giving. God of love, hear our prayer. We thank you for the commitment of our mission partners in the UK and globally to bringing about your kingdom through sharing the good news of Jesus. We know that for many of our partners, their mission work has taken on a new dimension during the COVID-19 pandemic. We pray that you will strengthen their faith as they face difficult circumstances and new challenges. May they know the peace, the power, and the presence of Jesus in their lives. God of love, hear our prayer. We pray that you will help our mission partners adapt to new ways of working so that they're able to reach those in need with compassion and hope. We pray for the continued spread of the gospel through their ministry. Please help them overcome any barriers that have been imposed through lockdown or other restrictions to enable them to share the good news of Jesus, to nurture new Christians, and to encourage all in their faith. God of love, hear our prayer. Many of our mission partners are involved in bringing practical relief to those whose lives are affected by poverty, war, or religious and ethnic divides. We pray that together with other aid organisations, they will be able to get food, financial aid and emotional support to people whose situations have become desperate because of the pandemic. We pray that governments will make well-informed decisions to reduce the spread of the disease. And we pray for wisdom and support for governments of developing nations who are not able to provide safety nets for their people because of lack of resources and fragile infrastructures. God of love, hear our prayer. God of compassion, we pray for all those in our church family who are unwell, those who are grieving the loss of loved ones, and those who are feeling isolated or lonely because of lockdown. Please bring relief and healing and give them the inner strength and hope that you alone can give. And finally, Heavenly Father, please help us to be a light where there is despair and darkness, so that people in our communities can recognise you in us as we live out the message of the gospel and build your kingdom. God of love, please accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
If you've had an opportunity to visit our website and particularly our mission page, you will have seen that the theme for our mission weekend is listen, pray and give. And we have heard from Anna Laszlo, and she has really encouraged us in how we can personally get involved in mission and what our role is. And we have prayed together and been led by Kate. And now we want to take an opportunity for you to consider how you are going to give. Again, we'd really encourage you to take time to look at those updates from many of our mission partners to hear how they're doing, and particularly how they are coping during the current COVID-19 situation and how it is impacting people right across our world. And then to take time to pray and to consider for yourself how you can give. No doubt, finances for many people are really stretched at the moment. But we believe in a God who is generous and who encourages us to be generous as well. So please do take time to consider and give. And in response to that, we want to give thanks for all that God has given and to say this prayer. And so I'd encourage you to join with me as we say, Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor and the majesty, for everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. Amen. And so as we finish our service together, we're going to sing again together. We're going to sing, Come Set Your Rule and Reign. And we're going to use this song as a prayer for our own lives and for our church and our church across this nation and beyond, that we would pray and seek and act to see God's kingdom coming in this world. Let's sing together.
Come say your rule and reign in our hearts again. Increase in us, we pray. Unveil while we may. Come set our hearts ablaze with hope, like wildfire in our very souls. Holy Spirit, come invade us now. As we are your church and we need your power. All right, let's go. We seek your kingdom first. We hunger and we thirst. Refuse to waste our lives, for you're our joy and prize. To see the captive hearts released, the hurt, the sick, the poor at peace.
It's been wonderful that we've been able to gather in this way this morning, that we've been able to sing together, to bring our hearts before God in confession, to hear from his word, and to be encouraged and equipped in mission. And then to consider what our response is. So thank you for joining us. And so as we draw our service to a close, may I pray this prayer over us and for us this morning. Draw your church together, O God, into one great company of disciples, together following our Lord Jesus Christ into every walk of life, together serving him in his mission to the world, and together witnessing to his love on every continent and island. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, come down among us. Come down upon us and remain with us always. Amen. Amen. And so go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. Thank you for joining with us this morning. Do join with us on Thursday evening for our Ascension Day service on Zoom at 7 p.m. And do get in touch if you'd like us to send the details for that service. And there are going to be a whole host of other resources available throughout Thy Kingdom Come. So please do check them out on the websites. And if you're not on our mailing list, please do get in touch. We'd love to add you to that so you can keep updated with all that we're doing to encourage and to equip one another in prayer and mission and worship during these times. So please do get in touch with us. We would love to keep in touch with you. Thank you and take care. Bye-bye.